Hi, this is Amy from the Altis store. Well, I've already shown you a video just kind of in general showing how shading affects panels. But what I wanted to do is show you a little bit more details and different options that you can take if shading is not avoidable, how you can wire your panels differently to help minimize the shading. So I have two identical 50 watt solar panels here. They're 12 volts. So their VMP, their maximum power output, is about 18 volts. And their IMP, their maximum current, is 2.78 amps. Now it is getting to be almost 4 o'clock, so I'm not gonna get perfect performance out of this, but I think that you're really gonna be able to see quite well how shading affects the panels. Now I'm gonna be talking about cells. Each solar panel is made up of a series of cells. So you can see here, this is one cell. So each cell puts out just over about a half a volt. So what you do is the silver that's going across here, this is wire that's wiring all of these cells in series so that it increases the volts, so the output becomes about 18 volts. Now, most of the 12 volt solar panels you'll see are actually 36 cell panels. These are 72 cell panels. These are Altis store panels. The reason that is they've actually got two parallel strings of 36. So we've got 36 cells wired in series, 36 cells wired in series, and then those two sets are wired in parallel. So just when I want to let you know when I'm talking about cells, that's what's going on, okay? Okay, so right now I just have one of these solar panels wired to my test setup. I've got the MPPT Midnight Kid charge controller going to my MK battery, 12 volt battery. So I've got a 12 volt panel right now just going by itself through the charge controller into the battery. And we can see that I've got coming right out of the solar panel, I have 14.9 volts and 2.46 amps. So that's pretty good considering I'm not at perfect conditions. And coming out of the charge controller to the battery is 12.6 volts and 2.59 amps. So you can see even when it's a 12 volt panel and a 12 volt battery, the MPPT does drop the volts and raise the amps a bit. So let's take a look at the power rating. So I've got 36.6 watts coming out of the solar panel into the charge controller, and then 32.7 watts going into the battery. So there's always gonna be a little bit of losses through any sort of equipment that you do, all right? So those are the numbers we're gonna be taking a look at. So here again is one cell of a solar panel. So I've got 72 cells. Now I wanna show you what happens if I shade one full cell of this solar panel. So I go from 2.45 amps with one cell shaded, I drop down to 1.7 amps. So you would think that, okay, well, boy, one cell dropping it down that much, what's two cells gonna do? That drops down to 1.4 amps, but you're gonna notice the volts isn't all that impacted. We're at 14.9 volts. If I shade the one, I'm still at 14.9 volts. Even if I start shading several of them, I'm really not seeing much difference in the volts. Where I see the difference is amps. So current is affected by shading. Now, let's take a look if I'm shading across multiple cells, but just a little bit of it. So I've got one, two, three, I've got six cells that I'm shading just about a quarter of them. I'm at 2.3 amps. That's actually not bad. 2.4. So the direction, what you shade is as important as where you shade. So you can see I'm shading the same amount. I'm shading out an entire cell versus same amount of shade versus a bunch of them, of just part of them. So keep this in mind when we continue on. We're going to show some demonstrations here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wire these two panels in series and see what shading one panel does to the whole array. All right, let's rewire to do that. Okay, so now we have these two solar panels wired in series. So our volts is 27.5 volts. So that's the two voltages pretty much added together. And then our current is 2.1 amps. So the current stayed about the same, because when you wire in series, the voltage increases and the current stays the same. So if we look at our output into the charge controller, our watts is doubled because we've got the two solar panels going in there now. So the volts again dropped from the higher voltage down to the 12 volts to charge my battery and increase the current to 4.28. So let's work on the shading. So if I start shading one string, now remember we've got, let's say we've got 55 watts going into the charge controller. So I'm going to shade one cell, and that's dropping us down to 36 watts. So shading one cell has brought us all the way down from over 59 watts down to 36 watts. So let's see shading multiple. Four really didn't do that much difference. We're at 32 watts, say. So the difference, again, wired in series, the difference between shading one cell and multiple cells is not all that different. That's for kicks and giggles, shade some from both. So one from both, we're dropped down to 36 watts shading both panels. So this is with them wired in series. So let me write down these volts, and we're going to rewire everything, and we're going to see what it does if I've got them wired in parallel. Alrighty? Alright, so now we've got the two panels wired in parallel. So you'll see that our current has doubled and our volts has stayed the same. So we're right around 15 volts. That's right around what we were seeing with just a single one. But our current is up to 4.49 amps. So let's say 4.5 amps. So we're doubled, or almost double what we were with just a single one. So now if we look at the watts, we're at 66 watts coming out. So again, it's all right in about the same ballpark that we had when we had the two of them wired in parallel, or wired in series. So now that we're wired in parallel with the pluses together and the minuses together, let's see what happens to the whole thing when we shade just one cell. So I'm shading this cell. Again, my volts really isn't doing much. I'm 16.6 volts, really not changing much. I'm going from 3.46 amps, 3.2 amps. Actually, that's not so bad. So let's shade a couple of them, 3 amps, 2.9. So now I'm starting to see some more substantial differences. But what's happening is, because we've wired these separately, each panel has got its own separate path to get to the battery. So shading just one of the panels is not going to be negatively impacting the other panel. Whereas when we had them in series, we were negatively impacting the whole series because everything had to go through the whole series. So the current was hitting a bottleneck when we shaded the one. So if we do shade a cell from both panels, then yep, we're going to drop down to say 2.6 amps. But again, the volts don't change all that much. So this kind of shows you that if you do have some partial shading and it's on only one of the panels at a time, so say you've got a chimney that you really have no control over, or if it's on a sailboat and you've got the mast that's kind of important, If you've got partial shading that's going to be changing, it's better to wire them in parallel to give the parallel path for the non-shaded panel. Ideally, and I know I say this a lot, each panel should have its own charge controller. That way you will get absolute maximum performance. But if it's not an option, wiring in parallel with partial shading is your better solution. I hope this was helpful. So give us a like and a share, and be sure to subscribe to our AltiStore channel so we'll notify you when we've got new videos coming out. And don't forget to go to our website at altistore.com, where we've been making renewable doable since 1999.